Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we'll try to understand piggybacking. So what this piggybacking that we will try to understand. In our previous classes where we have discussed about stop and wait, go back and selective repeat protocols, there we have understood, there we have seen that the communication is one directional in the sense. So far in our previous videos where we have discussed about the flow control mechanisms, there we have discussed it. If you haven't watched those videos, please watch those videos and come back here. And every video in our channel is going to be a part of entire course or a playlist. Our suggestion is to follow the entire course so that you can have better understanding of the concepts. There, in those videos, we have seen that the communication between the sender and receiver is unidirectional, in one direction only. So what we have stated is, for example, if you have sender and receiver, so we have seen that the sender is going to initiate communication, in the sense the data packets, the data frames are forwarded from sender to receiver, and in response the receiver is going to just send the response. The receiver will just send the response. This is how we have seen in our previous examples. But in real world, what happens is the data frames are transferred between both the senders and the receiver. So what it means is the sender is going to send the data, and in response the receiver will also send data. So this is what we call it as a bi-directional communication. In this kind of communication, our protocols, the protocols that we have used in our previous videos, they are going to use a concept called piggybacking. So what this piggybacking is, the acknowledgments that needs to be transferred by the receiver or by the sender, here the direction, the communication is bi-directional. So here the acknowledgments for the packets that are sent by the receiver or by the sender will be delayed for a certain amount of time, and whenever the other party is ready for transferring the data frame, within the data frame the acknowledgments will also get transferred. So what I am trying to make you understand is, for example, if the sender has sent a data frame, and for that the acknowledgement has to be, for that data frame the acknowledgement has to be transferred from receiver to sender. But in the piggybacking, so what this piggybacking concept will do is, the piggybacking means it is going to stop, it is not going to send the acknowledgement immediately after receiving. So what the receiver system will do is, it will wait for certain period of time. So until the data frame that needs to be transmitted by the receiver, so until that packet is ready for the transmission, it will wait, and during the data frame transmission, it will embed all the acknowledgments that needs to be transferred. So for example, if the sender is waiting for 4 acknowledgments, all those 4 acknowledgments will be combined in the data frame that is being transferred by the receiver. Within the data frame, the acknowledgments for all the 4 data frames will be embedded and it will get transmitted. So it helps us a lot in saving our time and transmission of acknowledgments separately. Okay, but there is a disadvantage with this system also. So what the disadvantage is, for example, so how much time does the sender has to wait? So it has to wait for lifetime. For example, sender has sent the data and there are no data packets for the receiver. So the data packet, there is no data packet to be transferred by the receiver. So what happens? Again, will it has to retransmit the data? No. So what the receiver will do is, it will wait for a specific period of time. So what that specific period of time is, it is less than the time of the timeout time. So for example, if the timeout time for sender is 15 seconds, and it is not having any data to be transmitted. So after 10 seconds, after 10 seconds of waiting by the receiver for the data frame, if none of the data frame packets has been received by the receiver for the transmission, then the acknowledgements will be directly transferred to the sender. So I've taken it for understanding, not exactly 15 and 10 seconds. So this is just for understanding. So what happens, what is the problem that we are going to have with the data, with the piggybacking, is if there is no data by the receiver to transmit, so how much time does the sender has to wait? Will it has to wait until it has to, it will send the acknowledgements? No. So because after timeout, again the retransmission is done. With that, the retransmissions will increase. With that, the traffic at the between the sender and the receiver will increase. To avoid that, what the receiver system will do is it will wait a specific period of time. After that time, if the data frames are not received by the receiver for the transmission, so the acknowledgements will get transmitted. So this is all about piggybacking concept. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding this concept, please post your doubt in the comment section below. And if you feel that this video is helpful to you, please give us a like symbol and please share this video with your friends so that they will also get benefited. Thanks for watching.